Strabismus following scleral buckling. Owner's pride, neighbor's envy. Let's begin with a story. Once upon a time, a patient came to a retina OPD with complaints of diminution of vision in the right eye. Best corrected visual acuity had reduced to 20/120 in the right eye. After fundus examination, a peripheral retinal detachment was diagnosed. An emergency scleral buckling procedure was performed. Visual acuity postoperatively became 6/6 in both eyes. That's awesome! But the patient was still unhappy because their eyes looked something like this. After a successful scleral buckling surgery, the retina surgeon is proud, whereas his neighbors, the friendly strabismologists, are googly-eyed on seeing the crossed eyes. Why did this happen? Well, there are multiple causes. It could be reaction to surgical trauma or the explant disturbing the functional direction of the muscle. It could be a direct trauma to the muscle or infected explant postoperatively can cause dissolution of the muscle. Correcting such strabismus is a road less traveled and lacks proper step-by-step guidelines. This video compilation is an attempt to provide just that. In the course of this video compilation, we shall discuss three similar cases with different management strategies. Our first case is a 23-year-old male who complained of diplopia and strabismus following scleral buckling surgery. On examination, he had 25 prism diopter exotropia with normal ocular motility. In such a case, first step is a trial of prism glasses. Here it worked fabulously and relieved the patient of diplopia. Second case is that of a 24-year-old male with strabismus and diplopia post scleral buckling surgery. He had 25 prism diopters of right exotropia with limitation in abduction. Prism glasses did not work here, so we planned for right lateral rectus recession surgery. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Wrong. Lemon squeezing can get messy too. On table, we hit a major roadblock. We found extensive fibrosis that made isolation of the muscle itself very difficult. After lateral rectus is identified, posterior adhesions have to be relieved. For successful recession, bleeders are identified and cauterized. Regular recession is then carried out. An amniotic membrane graft was used to prevent extensive fibrosis later on, as well as to cover the bare sclera as the conjunctiva was very much retracted. Day 1 post-op showed a mild exotropia. Second week post-op showed perfectly orthotropic happy patient. If life gives you lemons, make lemonade. Coming to the third case. 35-year-old male with similar history. On examination, vision in the right eye was PL positive and PR inaccurate with no diplopia. 5PD right hypertropia and 20PD exotropia, elevation, depression and adduction restriction. His chief complaint was cosmetic disfigurement. Our plan was to do a forced suction test, an inferior rectus resection and superior rectus recession. On table, we were totally blindsided. Only scar tissue was found at the site of inferior rectus and superior rectus insertion. We had entered an extremely complicated maze. We made a new surgical plan. The inferior oblique muscle was transposed to the inferior rectus insertion site. Nishida's procedure was done on medial rectus towards the inferior rectus muscle. Mitomycin pledgets were used to prevent extensive postoperative fibrosis. Postoperatively, there was a significant reduction of strabismus and cosmetic improvement was noticed. We had a happy patient. We finally got out of the complex maze in one piece. So, what's the take-home message? Try non-surgical means like prisms for small angled strabismus. Use appropriate measures like mitomycin C or amniotic membrane graft to prevent fibrosis. Consider modified strabismus surgeries like adjustable sutures and hangback techniques. Be flexible to change the pre-planned surgical course of action for the patient's benefit. After all, a stepladder is not always required to change a light bulb. An army of minions can do it as well. And last but not the least, multidisciplinary approach is required in all patients undergoing retinal surgery. Three cheers for all strabismologists. Hip hip, hooray! Thank you for watching the video.